lighting is terrible because the sun is slanted right in my garage door, but I'm going to start this rearrangement of the radiator on this engine. I want it to be up level instead of mounted down low. That way the vent will be up above the cylinder head. It'll make the pump's job easier, and it will definitely let the whole system be full of water instead of having a big air gap in the top. But to do that, I'm going to start. These are the three pipes that were removed. I guess who knows how this shot is working out, but this little one isn't getting modified because it goes out of the pump right into the lower entry on the motor, but I will be trimming the other two here because they're just going to turn into pipe nipples for this flexible tubing. So safety glasses, I'm going to cut off the edge. If I cut before that bend, it's going to be kind of short, so I guess we'll, cut this after the bend. Same on the other side. There. Packing with a drum. Used to do a lot of model railroading when I had space and time for it, and a lot of people get into stuff and then they see everybody using a Dremel and they ask, you know, what's it for? And I always said, a Dremel is one of those tools that you're going to get and you're never going to know what it's for until the first time you use it, and then it's going to be for everything. And you're like, oh yeah, I'll just hit that with a Dremel. Or, oh yeah, the Dremel can do that real quick. Let's see. Yeah, maybe that stone might be the answer to this. Switch out for that stone. Deburr the inside because I definitely don't want any restrictions on the water flow because it's such a small pipe to begin with. we go. I say we'll do this without getting caught on the end of that tool then. There we go. That got all the chips out of there. Now, I need to find a little block to put that radiator up on. So I guess I will be back when I have a better plan for that.